wants to wake up but can't remember how. No one should be here.
We need to find out what these Canari were up to. So let's go see, shall we? Looks like there was a bad cave-in. Look at all that. The Canari have a huge operation here.
But why?
This place isn't stable.
Once again, your mark is glowing. Are you all right?
Well, maybe the anchor can make itself useful down here.
Watch out!
How desperate are the Canari to work in these conditions?
After all the places we have been, I hardly expected to find us in another cave.
Come now, this isn't nearly the gloomiest cave we've been dragged to.
Look, someone...
Stay back!
Wait, your hand... Are you the Inquisitor?
Odd to find a human down in the deep roads at all. Let alone surrounded by Canari.
We don't have much time. Please, what the Vidisala is doing, you have to stop her.
The Vidisala?
She's the leader of the Canari here. She hates magic. Her job was to study it and stop it at all costs. Not anymore. I don't care whether you serve Fenharel or not. Someone has to stop her.
Why do the Canari think that the Inquisition serves Fenharel?
I don't know. The Vidisala said it, and the Canari here accept it as fact.
We've had agents of Fenharel causing trouble all over the crossroads. Sabotage, making spirits attack us. I assume the Inquisition was their army. That you came here because Fenharel told you to.
Who are you, exactly?
My name is Gerund. Sir Gerund, once. I was a Templar in Kirkwall, until I joined the Qun.
Your Canari?
Kirkwall was... madness. Chaos. The Canari were like the eye of a storm. I stand for order and discipline, protecting the innocent from magic. But this plan... it's as mad as Meredith ever was.
What do you mean? This Vidisala's not doing her job anymore?
Almost a complete reversal, actually. This place is Illyrium mining and processing center. The Canari need it for... Have you ever heard of Saravas?
I am one.
Even as a Templar, I've never seen anything like the power Saravas can unleash. And now Vidasala is giving them lyrium. A lot of lyrium. It's part of something she calls Dragon's Breath. There's more to it than that, but I couldn't find out what. The Qunari don't like it when you ask too many questions.
Where are we? Why are there elven mirrors in the deep roads?
This place is close to something like a lyrium spring. The more we mine, the more there seems to be. As for the mirrors, I don't know. Maybe the elves were mining here too.
What are you doing down here?
The Qunari wanted me to teach them everything I knew about lyrium. Where it comes from, everything it can do, how we put it to use. I knew enough from my time in the Order. They figured out more. I'm not sure how. Maybe they got to the Carter.
The Qunari can't be mining their own lyrium. It kills anyone who tries, other than dwarves.
It killed the Qunari at first. The Qunari workers have a discipline only Tranquil can match. And they're quick learners. They figured it out.
That's not seriously the name of the plant, is it? Dragon's Breath?
You know that most Dragon's Breath destroys everything in its path, right? She said it would save the South. That can mean only one thing. An invasion. This mine is the only source of lyrium the Qunari have. They're using Gatlock, the explosive powder in the round casks, to mine, so they don't have to touch raw lyrium. If you get the primers from Central Supply, you can prime the Gatlock and detonate it. The mines will go up in flames.
Even if I succeed, will that really stop the Vidasala?
It would be a start. Deepstalkers and cave-ins will cut off reinforcements, but they'll still come when they hear trouble. You've got to find the Vidasala to end this war before it begins.
There's no telling how bad things will get when I destroy the mine. You better get moving.
I will. Good luck, Inquisitor.
Let's go. We have a lyrium mine to ruin.
We saw the Qunari make these things explode. Maybe we can use them to get out of here.
It shouldn't be this dark. The dwarven buildings are lit by molten rock. That doesn't just go out.
Here they come!
Last time, it took an exalted march to stop the Kunari, and that barely worked. If they strike now, they thus may f-
Cold stone, dark tunnels, and surrounded by extremely hostile Kunari. Not the place I've chosen for romantic homecoming amongst the men.
I always wanted to try a wyvern down there.
There's one of the mining platforms. Now we just need primers.
What a well-oiled operation the Kunari have. I think we should explode it, don't you?
That Templar was telling the truth. The primers should be in here. We're almost there.
Imperium. I think I just heard the entire Magisterium cry out in envy.
You've got the primers. Let's go explode some Gatlong.
So the singing stones don't kill them.
That's it. Let's get out of here and warn the others about this dragon threat plan.
I doubt the Oxmen or that rising floodwater will make it easy for us.
We should see where that leads. Find another way.
Wife Fidel Cullen and Josephine were probably at war with the Kune. Anyone?
They're gonna kill me.
Dragon's breath. The Kunari always enjoy their metaphors. But what does it mean?
Who knows? Kunari agents moving through Illuvians to attack the south is bad enough already.
I still do not understand why they accused the Inquisition of serving Fennerel.
We know that Methal actually exists. It's possible Fennerel is still here in some form, too.
What you describe in the ruins certainly implies that the Dread Wolf of Elven legend is a real person. But how does that implicate us? What made them decide that the Inquisition serves this Fennerel? Hopefully we will learn more after we have stopped them.
Let's see the Exalted Council try to disband the Inquisition after we've saved them from this dragon's breath.
We must find out what Dragon's Breath is first. For now, our only lead is the Kunari leader, the Vidisala.
Gentlemen!
My apologies, Lady Josephine. There has been an incident with one of your soldiers.
How dare you! It was bad enough that the Inquisition chose not to inform the Exalted Council of the Kunari Corps.
Orle would have been happy to help with the matter.
But now your own guards are attacking servants? You have overstepped your bounds.
My plan to seize power in Ferelden would hardly start with soldiers scuffling in Orle, Arl Teagan.
While the Exalted Council is our foremost priority, the Inquisitor will, of course, address this matter personally.
Thank you, Inquisitor. Orle stands ready to assist the Inquisition, as always.
Secrets and lies. Do you understand why we fear your Inquisition? You act as if you're the solution to every problem. How long before you drag us into another war?
What's going on here?
The Orlesians tried to take one of our people, Inquisitor. We've secured the area.
This is the Winter Palace. You cannot simply seize control when one of your guards attacks a servant.
The Inquisition is handling this. When some noble commits a crime of fashion, you can take over.
I only asked what he was doing.
And when I refused to bow to the Inquisition, dogs, you attacked me. How would you like us to handle the situation, Inquisitor?
That barrel there. Where did it come from?
I was ordered to bring wine for the guests.
You're lying.
Your Inquisition soldiers are completely out of control.
No, we're in control. Keep talking and you'll find yourself in chains.
I apologize for my guard's actions. My people will take her into custody, with your permission.
As you say, Inquisitor. Lord Cyril will hear about this.
Inquisitor, I also found this by the barrel. I can't read the language. Did you resolve the problem with the guard?
The guard is the least of our problems. Someone smuggled Gatlock barrels into the Winter Palace.
Smile, Inquisitor. There are many eyes upon us. At least now we know the true extent of the dragon's breath.
How are you still smiling?
Years of training as a bard, Inquisitor. We cannot show weakness now. Enemies could be watching, or we can let them seize idle conversation between two friends.
You think the dragon's breath is these Gatlock barrels?
Of course. A surprise attack, even through the Illuvians, would have met fierce resistance. But if everyone at the Exalted Council died in an explosion, the South would be rudderless, vulnerable to attack. This is what Corypheus should have done after the explosion at the Temple of Sacred Ashes. An attack as swift and unstoppable as the breath of a dragon.
The guard who confronted the servant said she found this note near one of the barrels. It looks like Canary writing.
Let me see. I picked some up from the Iron Bull, though I'm told my accent is atrocious. These are orders for positioning the Gatlock in the palace. When duty has been performed, report to the Vidasala through the mirror marked by a bookcase.
I've been hoping to meet the esteemed Vidasala. How nice of her to invite us over.
Good. While you do that, I will have agents locate the Gatlock barrels and remove them safely. I will also send word to my foreign contacts. We must see where else this dragon could strike.
By a bookshelf. This should be it.
Let us get answers from this Vidasala.
Thank you. sort of old elven library?
It definitely saw a massive magical backlash some time ago.
Let's hope we can track down the Vidisala in all this.
Visitors, patrons, welcome. The halls are open.
What are you?
I am Stavik. I am a learning thirst. Come, know what has not been lost. New words, new stories. The Qunari would not approach, but we learned their words as well. If you wish to exchange knowledge, they congregate by the lower gate.
What did the old elves use this place for?
This is the Via Dithara, the living knowledge of the Empire. The libraries of every city, the wisdom of every court. A connecting place whose paths are in disarray.
What put this place into disarray?
The Via Dithara was made with world and fade. When they sundered, so did we. Paths broke, knowledge fragmented, many were trapped. I preserve their last words.
What were these old elves' last words?
What happened? Where are the paths? Where are the paths? God save me. The floor is gone. Do not let me fall. Do not let me... On this spot, that is all.
I'm looking for a Qunari called Vidisala. Do you know what she wants here?
Vidisala, yes. She uses scholars and mages for study. They fear this place, but they seek to know the Veil.
What does Vidisala want to know about the Veil?
I regret I do not have more information. I am sundered from myself. If you discover another one of me nearer the Qunari, I may know more. Kindly give it my greetings. I have not thought with myself for some time.
There must be thousands of years of history here. There must be so much you can teach us.
I will try to recall, honored patron, but there are gaps, breaks. Greetings, laughter, emasal, forms out of air, light, memories. And yet there are so many broken parts at every... Missing!
Stop, please, stop! You don't need to hurt yourself.
Yes, I... Wisdom from compassion. Yes, I will stop. Apologies. I knew all once. We knew. With the break, only fragments or knowledge new since the fall.
We'll be going now.
Know this. An unknown person, not of the Qunari, recently woke the librarians.
An unknown person? Could this be our agent of Fenderel?
The librarians facilitated learning before the fracture, before the fall. Now, beware them. They are unwell.
There, Qunari, on that upside-down island?
Shivering, wide awake, watching for demons. This isn't home. This isn't home at all.
That repaired some of the steps. Let's look around for more. The inverted alluvium must lead to the Qunari.
Did you notice? Your anchor is flaring up near magic. Elven magic.
It doesn't hurt when I cast spells. What's causing this?
I'm not sure. Tell us if it gets worse.
These Canari are dead, but there's not a mark on them.
Look at their eyes. They died in fear.
Welcome. Welcome. Listen to the last words of those who lived past the fall. How could the Dread Wolf cast a veil between the world that wakes and the world that dreams? The Evanuris will send people. They will save us. When have you last heard from the gods? When the veil came down, they went silent. What is this veil? What has Fenherel done?
Are these records saying Fenherel created the veil between our world and the Fade?
If it's true, that means the Fade and the waking world were once one and the same. Look at this place. Now that we have so many samples, how hard would it be to build Illuvians of our own?
Mirrors to places that mirror what you've seen in those places.
Is that approval? Hard to tell with you.
You want to bring some good, a piece of the past that aches to think it's lost.
After these past few years, it would just be good to create something magical that is also helpful for a change.
Is that wise?
If I get around to it, I'll send you an Illuvian, Cassandra. Striking women can never be flattered by too many reflections.
If you get around to it, shall I be forced to accept?
If they're gonna stuff me into politics, I've gotta have some fun on the side.
These blocks are heading toward that upside-down Illuvian.
Can we trust this magic?
It's a place of learning. Maybe this Vir de Thara is helping us find what we need.
Yeah.
Inquisitor, we must look at your hand.
The pain stopped.
The magic here wakes it. Familiar, strong, ripping apart again, all again.
More dead Canari, with terrified expressions.
Welcome, and listen to the last words of those who walked this place. If we get out of here, I will end Fen Harad. After he held back the sky to imprison the gods, the dread wolf disappeared. Lies. We must tear down the veil, the cities, the pathways. Without magic, they're crumbling. You're wasting your time. Fen Harad's veil has turned our empire to ruins.
So the ancient elven empire collapsed because the veil weakened magic?
If what we're hearing is true, this would have been a disaster beyond measure.
Do you realize what this means? What this place is? The actual history of the elves could change everything.
This looks like technical notes. What did the Canari come here to learn?
I recognize some formulas. The Canari are trying to prove theoretical magic of some kind.
That should be enough stairs. Let's see if we can reach the inverted alluvium now.
librarians.
Hello.
Deltals. Siram Biramalas, Chibera Milva.